Tonight, we're out with Nathan Whitehead and Paul Malkin in the Staffordshire countryside to tackle a fox problem. Tonight, the boys have left the lamps behind as they head into the darkness armed with the NiteSite Eagle and the NiteSite Spotter Xtreme. Nathan Whitehead is no stranger to Team Wild. We've tackled many fox problems with him over the last few years and he's developed a fierce reputation for knocking over Charlies. Nathan's preferred method of foxing is on foot and by using his trusty lamp, but he's been impressed with the capabilities of the NiteSite units in the past. Tonight, we've tasked him with leaving his lamp behind and only using the NiteSite Eagle Spotter Xtreme combo. Can Nathan still deliver for the farm owners without his lamp? There's only one way to find out.
Hi there, it's Nathan Whitehead out again tonight for Team Wild. I've had a phone call again off another farmer. She's due to start lambing beginning of November and she's seen quite a few foxes about, so she wants us to come and try and sort them out. I've been baiting an area up 200 or 300 yards across the field here for the last week, and I know there's definitely two foxes coming to it. We brought the 22-250 out again to Howitt, 1500 stainless heavy barrel. We're out tonight with the NiteSite spotter. We've used it before, it was a good tool. And last time we were out, we used the NiteSite Wolf, which was absolutely brilliant. Tonight we're going to use the NiteSite Eagle, so that's supposed to be the top notch. So we're going to see what this one's like tonight and go from there.
Once the guys are set up, they head off into the night. The farmer has spotted several foxes moving across one piece of land, so the boys head there first. They use the spotter Xtreme to scan the darkness without fear of spooking any foxes hiding in the surrounding undergrowth. This farm is vast and there's plenty of open spaces. The NiteSite Eagle and NiteSite Spotter Xtreme both have identification ranges of up to 500 metres, which is perfect for scanning these fields. They can scan the darkness in every direction looking for a fox to make its way out of the hedgerows, and without the lamp to spook them, they just need to wait for it to come within shooting distance. They haven't been out very long before they spot a pair of eyes on the NiteSite Spotter Xtreme.
They're spotters, these. Good bit of kit. See, he's just sitting there, doesn't even know that we're here. Hasn't got a clue that we're here. Fantastic. We've been sat here now for a good 5 minutes and it's just sitting out there. We can't just quite get it come this way, but it will do, eventually. It's a nice bit of kit.
It's coming this way slowly now.
So,
he's probably about 200 yards out across there, but I want him to come slightly closer, baiting this side of that tree, and I know that's roughly about 80, 90 yards, so that, you know, I could probably hit him at 200, but I don't want to. Don't want to miss him. I don't like missing him.
They give it a squeak, but it isn't interested. The fox does stop though, cautiously waiting, but not alarmed. The guys sit and watch the fox. Without the lamp, he hasn't spotted them and it looks relaxed. However, it isn't coming any closer. The guys heed caution and wait a little longer. This Charlie seems totally oblivious to their whereabouts. guys, wait it out a little longer. Across the other side of the field, there are bunnies playing in the field, but it's this fox that they're after. They've been tasked by the farmer with dealing with the problem foxes. The guys keep on squeaking, but the fox has had enough and it heads off in the opposite direction. At the edge of the field, it stops, then begins to make its way down the hedgerow. The boys move across the field and try to head it off. They get set into a position and wait for it to come closer. Nathan waits. He picks his spot.
Hey!
And he fires. The shot is good and the fox is down.
Hopefully we've got that on film. The fox has come out again. I don't know whether it's the same one or a different one, but he's come out. Walked right across the field, lay down probably, I don't know, 300 yards across there. And he slowly, slowly made his way across. And then we just got him in a... He's just walked into a field of turnips and we've managed to take him out there. I don't know, he's probably about 120, 130 yards there, so... Yeah, that'll do. Right, we've just had him. He's probably... I don't know, 120 yards, 130 yards. He was just doing a bit of a U-rounders, and if I'd left him any further, he'd probably got all wind, so we took him here, but we've actually had a really good backstop here. You can actually see where the bullets come out of the fox and gone into the tater for us here. But no, it's been, the night sight's performed again. And the spotter is absolutely fantastic.
It was a good bit of kit. You could see everything clearly. You know, you see what he's doing. You know, how many furrows he come over near enough. You know, you could see everything. Like, it was brilliant, really.
Yeah, you do get some foxes that people have been out after them before, and they've been shot at and missed or whatever. That they will not stand in a lamp. So. This is where this comes into its own, you know, they don't even know you're there.
Tonight has been a waiting game for Nathan and Paul, but without a lamp to give away the location, the fox hasn't been spooked. It hasn't run, and they've been able to sit and watch it for some time. When the time was right, Nathan took his shot. That's another fox down, and the farmer's safe for one more night. To find out more about the amazing range of NiteSite products on offer, visit NiteSite.com. Subscribe to Team Wild TV for all of the best hunting videos on the web and choose one of the links below to see another amazing night vision hunt.